Hello friends, welcome to Saka. I am Vijay Tavade. Today is a very special day. On 1st of February 2020, Union Budget has been presented in Parliament. Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman presented the Modi government's Union Budget. And while presenting the budget has been framed on three basic points. She talked about aspirations of people, then economic development, and caring society. These are the basic three points on which the budget has been framed. So we'll just quickly summarize what are the different provisions and what we got from the budget. Let's start with the income tax lot, because everyone of us are interested in income tax. So we are very curious about what are the provisions in income tax. So government has made two kind of provisions, like the existing income tax system will be continued, or you can go for new income tax system. The system will be like this: up to 2.5 lakhs the tax is exempted. From 2.5 to 5 lakhs 5% tax will be there. From 5 lakhs to 7.5 lakhs 10%, 7.5 to 10 lakhs 15%, 10 to 12.5 lakhs 20%, 12.5 to 15 lakh 25%, and from 15 lakhs onwards 30% of income tax you have to pay. Or else you can go for previous existing system, in which you can give you can get some additional benefits. Along with this, dividend distribution tax has been abolished by government, and with this no company has to pay the tax on the dividend which they are giving to shareholders, while the shareholders have to pay the tax on the dividend amount they are getting in their account. Another important provision in income tax is regarding the home loan. Based on affordable housing scheme, the government has introduced additional 1.5 lakhs tax exemption for the taxpayers. With this, I think the tax segment over. Government is going to launch the IPO for LIC. LIC will be now listed in government. Government want to raise a lot of capital, because we know there is a lot of fund scarcity. So government will be listing LIC. Along with that, government had given lot of provisions for agriculture sector. Like as earlier said, government will be doubling the farmers' income by 2022, and with this lot of emphasis will be given to rural development. 2.83 lakh crores provision has been made for rural development. In that, agricultural products, irrigation, and all other things will be included. Solar energy is the major concern for the government, and government will be providing 22,000 crores to solar energy development. Nowadays we know that because of climate change and certain environmental issues, there is a lot of emphasis on unconventional or non-conventional energy sources. Solar energy is one of that. So government will be emphasizing solar energy. Again, chemical fertilizers is the another concern for government. So subsidy will be reduced for those fertilizers. As far as health sector is concerned, by 2025 TB has to be completely eradicated from India, and for that 69,000 crores rupees will be additional given to health sector. Another important sector, that is education sector. National education policy has been introduced, and with this skill development is the key area. 3,000 crores rupees will be provided for this skill development. For exporters, some Navic scheme has been introduced, and with the help of this there will be a lot of emphasis to resolve so many cases which are pending for the exporters. For industry and commerce, 27,300 crores provision has been made. Infrastructure is the another key sector where government always looks for. Currently 6,500 projects for infrastructures are in the pipeline, and for that 1.7 lakh crores provision has been made. Even for Bangalore, urban transportation project has been a key concern for government, and it has cost of 18,600 crores. Out of that, 20% equity share will be taken by central government. डिजिटल इंडिया इज अनदर की मोटिव और की पॉलिसी फॉर मोदी गवर्नमेंट. सो गवर्नमेंट विल बी फोकसिंग ऑन कंप्यूटिंग एंड सर्टन टेक्नोलॉजीज. नेशनल मिशन ऑन क्वांटम कंप्यूटिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी विल बी द न्यू एरा फॉर दैट. एंड 8,000 crores रुपीज प्रोविजन हैज बीन मेड फॉर दैट. अगेन इंटरनेट इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इन नाव डेज. सो भारत नेट इज द अनदर स्कीम फॉर दैट. 6,000 crore रुपीज प्रोविजन इज मेड फॉर दैट. 100 new airports will be established by 2025. So there is a lot of emphasis on aviation sector also. Even Chennai-Bangalore expressway will be established. For defense sector, 41,71,000 crores provision has been made. So there are other so many provisions, but with this I think the market has given negative reaction. Sensex tanked by almost 900 points throughout the day. So it was a quite negative reaction, but this is all of regarding the budget. So for this point, it is goodbye from my side. That is what I have to say regarding the budget. Thank you.